If you need to share some limited access to your Airtable data, but you don't want to add new Airtable users, and you don't really want to build a full-blown portal, well, you're in this middle ground where a mini portal might be your perfect solution. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to build a mini portal using login authentication, either with email or through standard Google login, all in Fillout. So if learning about mini portals for your Airtable users is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools like Airtable, and very often one of the most common problems for Airtable users is sharing access to external users, people who don't necessarily have Airtable access, and you might want them to do some light editing within some sort of process or system. But you don't really need that full-blown portal as I described. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to get that mini portal up and running quickly using Fillout. But before we get started, I want to invite you to join me for some free training. We've put together a free Airtable crash course that's going to teach you all the basics of Airtable so that you can really master the fundamentals and improve your workflows and business with Airtable. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and it'll be sent right to your inbox so that you can start watching that training in bite-sized chunks. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen, and I'm going to show you the basics that we need for our portal. So first and foremost, we need a users table, and this is where we're going to store, at a minimum, the email address of our users. So you can see I've got three fake users here, and I've added my own email address to one of them, specifically Keanu Sheaves. And I want this here so that I can demonstrate some testing purposes. And I would suggest that when you're building a mini portal of any kind, that you have your own email address in here at least to test. Now you can also see that I've brought in the user record ID, and this is going to come into play in our Fillout build. And I've also linked this to the tasks table. And the reason for this is I want something to display in my little mini portal other than just the user information. So here is where I'm linking to tasks, and each user is assigned to some tasks. In this case, Keanu has tasks 1, 2, and 3. And I'm also, very important here, looking up the record ID from the users table. We're going to use this record ID to limit, to filter the information that our logged in people can see in our mini portal. Let's now swing over into Fillout and we'll start building from scratch. We'll create the new form. Notice that this is going to be a blank form from scratch, and we can choose our theme. I'm going to go with Navy Pop, and we're going to create the form. Once we get set up here, of course, we can name the form. I'll call this User Portal Mini, and let's go ahead and continue. The first thing we want to do is find the login page feature. So I'm going to swing on over here and just start typing and drop this in. We can rename the page if we would like. I don't need to do that right now. Now I need to call out that this particular page is requiring you to be on the starter plan with Fillout or better. So if you just have a free account, you will need to upgrade to the next level up, the minimum plan that has a paid level for Fillout. The starter plan is where you get access to this login page, so just that free plan is not going to cut it. But this is pretty typical for most, you know, portal type of software. You're going to have to pay something in order to get people here. And the best part is there really isn't a limitation to how many people can have this access, so long as you have the ability to add new records in your Airtable users table. You can share this with however many people you can fit in that table. All right, so now inside of the page, you'll notice that we get verification type options. Number one is email, and for login methods, we can choose email and Google. Those are the two options that we get, but we can remove one of them if we don't want them both. I would recommend keeping the edit existing responses off. That's not something I typically toggle on. You can add or change the button text. Here I have it's defaulting to verify email. You can also limit submissions. You can restrict specific domains so that only certain people can log in. But the truth is, we're going to make sure that they are in our users table, so it's probably not going to be an issue here. You can also limit them to just one submission. Most of the time for a user portal like this, you're not going to want that. You're going to want them to have multiple submissions over time. Next, we're going to get to the integration component, and this is where we need to actually get it talking with our Airtable. So we don't yet have it connected to a database. We're going to have to do that. Let's go ahead and click on connect, and we'll select Airtable here, and we have a connection already established. If you don't, scroll on down, connect a new account, and follow the steps on the screen. I'll click next, and we have to choose the database. And we have our only one database here, the Fillout login example database that we were sharing on our screen right here. So let's go ahead and integrate with that. And here's the part where you might get tripped up. What we are trying to do here is integrate with our users table. We might want our users to take action on tasks, but this particular page has to do with who is logging in. So we have to get it synced up here, looking at our users table. Once we're set here, we can continue, and we get to this page, which is saying, what do you want your users to do? Do you want them to create new records? Do you want them to update existing records? And the fact of the matter is, you might not want them to do either one of those things. Let's imagine a scenario for our example so that we can kind of walk through the logic. Here in Airtable, we have users that are assigned to tasks, and maybe what we want is for our users to log into their little mini portal and tell us which of their tasks are complete. Maybe they just select those tasks from a dropdown, and we only want them to see their tasks, number one, and we want the action after the fact to be that the task gets updated from in progress to complete. That's what we want to have happen. We don't want to update or create new users. But the thing is, we have to integrate to the users table to use the login page. So how do we get the functionality that we want from our mini portal? Well, I'm going to teach you a little bit of a hack. I don't want to do either of these actions, create record, update record. I don't want either of these things to happen because this has to do with the users table that we have integrated with. So I'm going to set up an impossible condition that says I only want this integration to run when an impossible condition is true. Let's say, for example, the logged in user's email is 1@sample.com. Now, it might be possible that we find somebody with this email address, but if we add another condition where the email equals 2@sample.com, well, it's absolutely impossible that the logged in user will ever have two email addresses at the same time of logging in, because only one email address can ever log in at a time. So this is now an impossible condition, which means that this integration will never run. We'll never create a record. We will never update a record. And that's what we want. We don't want a new user or an updated user. We want to update the status of the tasks in the task table that the user selects. So let's now finish our setup. That little hack right there is going to save you a lot of back and forth trying to figure out what in the world is going on in your integration. We've now set it up so that nothing will happen when the user submits the information, but we can still limit who logs in and make sure that they see the tasks that they're assigned to. Let's get to work on that. So we're going to go with the email option for logging in, which means that when they sign up or log in, go to sign in, they will receive a security code from Fillout. We could also choose the password option, which allows them to set up a password. But for our purposes, we'll just stick with email. It's a little bit simpler. Let's go into the next stage of this now, and that's going to be our page where we actually do something. So now that the user is logged in, what do we want them to do? Well, I'm going to get rid of this little search for login. And now that we're integrated with Airtable, we see that we've got the tasks option here. This is representing the tasks field that we have in our users table. So whatever action you want your users to take in your mini portal, you have access to all of the information associated with that logged in user, assuming that you've already built that in Airtable. So I can allow my user to activate the email, the tasks, and of course they can't do anything to this formula field. So I want them to take some action on those tasks. Let's go back to our little mini portal here in Fillout, and we're gonna select tasks, and we can update this to say, select tasks that you have completed. That's good. All right. Now, we can preview this and we're going to see a bunch of tasks, task 1 through 9, because this is what we have in our database. We do not want our users to see all of these tasks. So we need to open the settings here on the side and go down to the advanced option. Here we can choose a filter. So we can apply the filter, and you might remember in our Airtable database that we have on the tasks table this user record ID. This is the record ID that we're looking up from the user table. So if we go back here, we can actually use that record ID, the user record ID in the tasks table that we look up from the users table must be equal to the logged in user's record ID. In order to get there, we need to make sure that that user record ID that lives in the tasks table is equal to the ID that came from the user who logged in. But we don't have the logged in user here yet because we missed a step when we were integrating the user on the login page. Let's back it up for just a second to the login page again. And we need to go back to integration. The piece that I always forget to do here is to say connect the database. Because of the fact that I felt like we already go through the steps of connecting the database, I always forget that I need to take this one extra step when I'm complete. So again, come back here after you've already integrated to your users table, make sure to toggle this on. Then you have to choose your base again and choose your users table. And most importantly, choose your email field. That way we know exactly who's allowed to log in. If they do not have an email in that table, in Airtable, they're not going to be allowed to log in. Now that we're done with this, we can move back to what we were doing on the filter. We can go back here, edit our filter. The user record ID that we looked up that now lives in the tasks table must equal, and here we have the user access. So let's drill into the user. The user record ID. That's simple. So now we can say with some certainty that when we look at this list, it's gonna be filtered. Now I'm not currently previewing this page, so if I went through the steps of logging in, then of course this would be filtered down for me. You might also look at this and say this isn't quite what you want the user to see. Maybe you don't want them to see the user record ID because you know they don't need to know that. Maybe you don't need them to see the status, or maybe you do. In any case, you can choose what shows up on these records right here that the user will see. Here in the advanced settings, choose the fields to show. So select, let's say, the name and the status, but we don't want to show that user record ID. You might also choose what they can search by. I don't want them to search by a status field, so I only want them to search by the name of the task that they want to update. So I'll say search by the name. And those are the settings that we need. So we can go ahead and publish this and take it out for a spin. I'm going to open up the newly published link now, and we will give it a shot. Now, I'm automatically logged in as me, so let's zoom back out and start this over from scratch. This is what somebody will see the first time they come to this form. So I'm going to use my actual email address, and that's going to, when I click here, send an email to my Gmail account. So let's go ahead and swing on into Gmail. And this is the code I just got. Let's go ahead and pop back here and I'll plug it in here with a little paste and continue. Now I'm logging in as me. And if we go back to Airtable, you'll remember that my email address is associated with Keanu. And the tasks that are associated here are task 1, 2, and 3. So those are the ones that I should see if we set this up correctly. Let's go ahead and do a new submission here. And I will only see the tasks associated with my personal account. Let's say I have now completed task 1 and I want to let the owner here or the manager know that, and I submit the form. Now we could do a lot with this ending page, which you probably know if you've already used Fillout, but we can do a, you know, allow people to submit again. We can also come back to our page here and allow them to choose multiple records. So we can toggle this on. And we can also give them even more advanced things like creating records and editing records that are associated and linked to them. Now, because this is a mini portal, we're not gonna go too far down that rabbit hole in this video. What I wanna show you now is what we do with the information we just received. Because if we look at our results on this form, we will see that this person logged in, they submitted something that said, task one is complete. But if we go back to Airtable, this still shows as in progress because we have not built any kind of automation to update this task. So let's do it. We can do this quite simply back in Fillout by applying a workflow. So let's do a quick integration here. I'm going to move over to integrate and choose workflows up at the top, and I'm going to build a blank workflow. I'm going to say when this form is submitted, I want to send a webhook to Airtable. Webhooks can be a little intimidating if you've never used them. I'm going to show you step by step how easy it is to set this up. So first, we're going to head into Airtable's automations. And we're going to say when a webhook is received. This is going to trigger an automation, and Airtable is going to give us this webhook URL. Think of this as a phone number that Fillout is going to call and share specific information to that will trigger this automation. So let's head back into Fillout and we're going to paste in that webhook. Now, I really like to go into the advanced view here and I'll create a body. And what I'll do here is create the thing that I want to pass to Airtable. So I will say tasks, record IDs. And right here, we're going to grab the tasks and we'll do the record IDs that came from this submission. So let's say done. And let's test this. I want to test this with the information that we just received when we sent through the form for task one. So I grab this, run the workflow. Let's head back into Airtable now and let's test our trigger. This is the webhook basically picking up the other side to see what it received. And it got this string of record IDs. Now what we want to do is update the records for which we received the record IDs. Basically, we want to update the tasks that have been marked complete. So we're going to set this up in a step here that says update the record where the task table has the record that we got here, the record ID that we got from the webhook. And what we want to do with that is update the status to be complete. Pretty simple, right? So if we generate a preview, we're going to see that we identified task one as complete. And so that is going to update the status. Let's go ahead and run this entire automation. We'll run as configured just to validate that it worked appropriately. We'll turn it on and we'll go back to our data layer and confirm that now Keanu logged in, submitted that one task was complete, and it's now updated. Now, lastly, we have to go back to Fillout to make sure that we publish our integration as well, because this is going to send the record IDs for the tasks that we get in our form and send them to Airtable. So we need to make sure that we turn on both sides of this, the automation in Airtable, as well as the workflow in Fillout, so that when we receive the form, we talk to Airtable and Airtable can take its actions. Turning on the workflow by itself isn't quite enough. We still have to make sure that we publish the form again. So make sure that you not only turn on the workflow and the automation in Airtable, but then also publish the form from Fillout to make sure that everything's working. Now, one thing I do need to call out, the way that I built the automation here in Airtable is for one record only. So we would need to actually complicate this a little bit if we are allowing our users to submit multiple tasks at the same time. Our automation is only built for one record, so we would need to build a more robust automation. But for the purpose of this video, the simple single record automation was perfectly sufficient for our mini portal needs. I hope you got a ton of value from this. I know we did go quickly and there's a lot to unpack here. So if you have questions that we did not answer in the video, swing by our website because we have put a ton of resources together to help you do more with no code. If you liked this video, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel so you see more content just like this to help you level up. But most importantly, keep on building.